Jays fans. I'm sitting here with senior center Gregory Echenique. We are going to ask all the questions that you've been dying to ask. Gregory, first question.
Yep.
Como te amos?
Oh.
Did I say that wrong?
Yeah, you did. It's actually como te llamas.
Como te llamas.
And, oh.
Roll it again. Creighton J. Como te amos, mi amigo.
Yo, Gregory Echenique, tú?
Grant Gibbs.
Oh. Hey, actually, when I first got here, when they asked me that, and I used to say Gregory, they used to never figure out my name because I used to roll the R too quick. And every time I say Gregory, they used to look at me weird. So then I learned that I have to say Gregory. I have to like add the R. So you might want to know that.
So you prefer to be called Gregory, not Gregory. Is that correct?
No, I would rather if you can call me Gregory. I mean, I would prefer that. That's actually how they call me home.
Okay.
Better than Greg too. They don't call me Greg over there.
Fans, he'd like his name pronounced Gregory, not Gregory. Or do you say the other way?
The other way.
Right. Next question for you, and I've been dying to know this one. You've played with a lot of good players. Played at Rutgers, St. Benedict's, Venezuelan national team, numerous camps. Who is the best post feeder in terms of throwing the ball in the post that you have ever played?
Wow.
I gotta know.
Wow, I was not expecting that one. I will give it to, I play with Corey Fisher, actually. I play at, sorry, I don't know if you were expecting to say your name, but.
I gotta be top five.
Hey,
I gotta be
you
top
might
five.
Be. I mean, we still got one more year to go.
Top five.
Everything
okay.
could, a okay. good chance after this year.
I'm a little hurt, I'm gonna be honest.
Hey.
But I appreciate your honesty, okay?
Hey, that's fine with me.
Okay, all right, let's talk music for a sec. As you said, I'm your roommate, so as of late, I've been hearing a different style of music coming from your room that maybe the Creighton fans wouldn't expect. So tell us a little bit about your new music interest.
All right, well, I'm pretty open-minded when it comes down to music. And yes, I mean, I'll admit, lately, I've been liking country music a lot more than I expected. And I'm not ashamed to say it, so we'll see where that goes.
You've become known for the pink shoes that you wear.
Mm-hmm.
And so you got the pink shoes. High socks, right?
Is
there anything else that you wear that's a little different?
Well, I'm actually
anything
not.
Anything at all.
I'm not doing the high socks this year. I'm actually doing two sleeves. And I know you want me to talk about the goggles since you're wearing them. It's kind of weird. I used to think goggles were actually, you know, kind of funny in people.
Right,
and now
right,
I end up, you know, having to wear them. And it's all for protection. I had a detached retina. I got poked in the eye during a practice, one of my old school. And so that kind of took me out of basketball for almost a year. But I'm healthy now. I just wear them for protection.
Okay, let's talk women for a sec.
Oh.
Compare Central American women to American women. Which you prefer? Your thoughts.
Oh, my God. Well, actually, I'm from South America. but I'll compare it.
Did not
I don't know. All I got to say is Venezuela has the most Miss Universe crowns. We got more than any other country, so you can Google that. It's actually a fact.
Are you positive that Venezuela is in South America?
Oh, well, you can go check. I mean, I think I was born there.
Here's a map of Venezuela.
Venezuela, that is in South America. It's close to Central America, though.
I don't know. All well, right. We're in the middle of Brazil, Colombia, and we're in the middle right there.
Right, so Jays fans, it's Gregory Echenique. He's from Venezuela, which is in South America.
There you go.
Cleared that up.
It's perfect. South America, and we got the most Miss Universe crowns out of every other country. Important
fun
fact.
We're learning all kinds of
that.
Stuff. PBS, we told you we were going to make it educational. Here we are.
Yep.
Here we are.
Yep.
That's about all we got today, folks. Learned a lot about Gregory Echenique. Clearly, our interview had a little more journalistic integrity than Doug McDermott or Jahan's Manigat. Might even have been up there with the great Nick Baugh and his counterpart, Nate Funk. You got the call. Until next time, thank you.